Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video, we are going to see how to find the derivative of parametric functions. Let us start. Find dy by dx. If x is equal to 2t upon 1 plus t square and y is equal to 1 minus t square upon 1 plus t square. Here, x and y are both given in terms of t. Thus, they become parametric functions. It is 2t upon 1 plus t square. Differentiating the above function, with respect to t. The derivative of x with respect to t will be dx by dt. Here both numerator and denominator are in terms of t. We will use u by v rule. That is v 1 plus t square into derivative of u. Derivative of 2t will give you 2 minus 2t into derivative of v, 1 plus t square, its derivative will be 2t again, as derivative of 1 will be 0 and t square derivative will be 2t upon v square, 1 plus t square, the whole square. Further on solving, we have dx by dt is equal to, multiplying 2, we get 2 ones are 2, plus we have 2t square, minus 2t into 2t will give you 4t square divided by 1 plus t square, the whole square. On further solving, we will get dx by dt is equal to 2. 2t square minus 4t square will give you minus 2t square upon 1 plus t square, the whole square. If you take 2 common in the numerator, you will get 2 into 1 minus t square upon 1 plus t square, the whole square. Similarly, we will find dy by dt. We have y as 1 minus t square upon 1 plus t square. Differentiating the above function with respect to t. Derivative of y will give you dy by dt. Here again we will go for u by v rule. That is 1 plus t square into derivative of 1 minus t square. Derivative of 1 will give you 0 minus derivative of t square will give you 2t minus 1 minus t square into derivative of 1 is again 0 and derivative of t square is 2t divided by v square, that is 1 plus t square, the whole square. Dy by dt is equal to, again multiplying minus 2t to both these terms, you will get minus 2t into 1 is minus 2t, minus into plus is minus, 2t into t square will give you 2t cube, 2t into 1 will give you minus 2t, minus of minus is plus, 2t into t square will give you 2t cube divided by 1 plus t square, the whole square. If you see, minus 2t cube plus 2t cube will be cancelled and dy by dt will consist of minus 2t minus 2t, that is minus 4t divided by 1 plus t square, the whole square. Now dy by dt is also ready. We can say by derivative of parametric functions, dy by dx can be written as dy by dt upon dx by dt. In dy by dt we have minus 4t upon 1 plus t square by whole square, and in dx by dt we have 2 into 1 minus t square upon 1 plus t square, the whole square. If you see, the same denominator will be cancelled and further we have minus 4t upon 2 into 1 minus t square. Again we have 2 1s are 2 2s are. The final answer of dy by dx will be minus 2t upon 1 minus t square. This becomes the derivative of the given function. Let us see the next problem. In problem number 4, we have if x is equal to e raised to cos 2t, y is equal to e raised to sin 2t, then prove that dy by dx is equal to minus y log x upon x log y. Let us see for the x first. X is given as e raised to cos 2t. Differentiating the above function with respect to t, we have derivative of x as dx by dt. This being the exponential composite function, derivative of e raised to cos 2t will be e raised to cos 2t into derivative of cos 2t will give you minus sin 2t, and again this being a composite function, derivative of 2t will be 2. This becomes the derivative of this function. Similarly, y is given as e raised to sin 2t. Differentiating the above function with respect to t, derivative of y will be dy by dt. Here we have e raised to sin 2t, its derivative will be e raised to sin 2t. T is replaced by sin 2t, its derivative will be cos 2t. Here in cos, the t part is replaced by 2t, its derivative will be 2. Dx by dt, dy by dt, both are ready. Further we can say by derivative of parametric functions, we can write dy by dx is equal to dy by dt upon dx by dt. Dy by dx becomes, in dy by dt we have e raised to sin 2t into cos 2t into 2 upon dx by dt we have e raised to cos 2t into minus sin 2t into 2. Now the relation that they have asked to prove is dy by dx as minus y log x upon x log y. And the terms which we have obtained is e raised to sin 2t into cos 2t into 2. So here in this case, we need to eliminate these terms and convert these t terms in terms of x and y. How to do that? Let us consider this as equation number 1. If you see, the value of x was given as e raised to cos 2t. Now, to find the value of cos 2t in terms of x, we can take simply log on both sides. If you take log on both sides, here we have log x, and here after taking log, we have log e raised to cos 2t. On continuing further, we get log x is equal to log e raised to m will give you m log a, that is cos 2t into log e. We also know that the value of log e is 1, therefore log x will be equal to cos 2t. Also, similarly, we can find the value of sin 2t using the value of y. The value of y was given as e raised to sin 2t. If we take log on both sides, here we will get log y is equal to log of e raised to sin 2t. On further solving, we will get log a raised to m is m log a, that is sin 2t into log e. Again, the value of log e is 1. So further we have log y is equal to sin 2t. We have successfully converted cos 2t and sin 2t, cos 2t and sin 2t in terms of log and log. Cos 2t is equal to log x and sin 2t is equal to log y. So this part is obtained. Now how to obtain these two parts? e raised to sine 2t, we know already it is equal to y, and e raised to cos 2t, we already know it is x, and the remaining part 2 will be cancelled. Now let us substitute the value of e raised to sine 2t, e raised to cos 2t, again cos 2t and sine 2t in equation number 1. We will say substitute the values of e raised to sine 2t, e raised to cos 2t, cos 2t and sine 2t in equation number 1. And let us see the change. Dy by dx is equal to e raised to sine 2t, the value was y, into the value of cos 2t was log x, divided by the value of e raised to cos 2t was x, into keeping minus sign as it is, the value of sin 2t was log y. Here we get dy by dx is equal to, taking minus sign in the numerator, we have y log x upon x log y. Here we have proved this problem. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe Ekeeda.